as if to greet the mist that falls upon them from the skies. Dark, dark thy hills, and darker still thy mountain torrents flow, but none so dark as Wilmoret's heart in his castle. That gently flow by hot and hall beneath the bright sunbeams. But glen or stream or meadow green or flower upon the lea were not more mild than when Wilmoret's child, so sweet and fair was she. Stout brought thy oak, O Donegal, and straight thy Gashan tree, and swift and straight thy son so tall, our country's pride to see. But oak or rush or young men all that spring from Irish soil were not more stout, swift, straight, and strong than the chief of Clan O'Boyle. He was the pride of Faugherside from the hills of Ballymore. For feats of strength none equaled him from Fanna to Gador. And he would go through the frost and snow on a merry Christmas day with the ringing a cheer to hunt the deer from his haunts in Darkland Bay. With hook and line to like a stream that runs by castle door. High in the castle tower is loud one lake confined, and on its lofty battlements in sorrow deep she pines. The castle strand two boats lay manned to wait the rising tide. Wilmoret there in chief command right cowardly did hide. And when O'Boyle his homeward course steered by the bishop's isle, they were waylaid and a prisoner made of fearless young O'Boyle. They brought him to the castle in strong Ireland's he was bound, and by Wilmoret was confined to a dungeon underground. But in a few days bore a bier wrapped in She cast a gaze upon the graveyard green, all pale and dead beside a mound of freshly risen soil. The pall removed, she there beheld the features of a boil. Then with the shriek she mounted.